So in this tutorial, we'll create these cool neon donuts in Blender. Okay, so first I'm just gonna delete the default cube. So you can just select the cube and press your delete key. Okay, now I'll quickly select this lamp and I'll go under the lamp settings. And as you can see, by default, this is a point lamp. So I'll just change it to a sun lamp. And the strength is too much, so I'm just gonna reduce the strength. Now you can change the color and the specularity. I'm just gonna leave the color as it is, and I'm just gonna reduce the specularity. And one more thing, we need to change the background color of the world. So I'll go in the world settings and I'll change the color to completely black. Okay, so now our environment and our lighting is done. So we'll start working on our donut. Now for the donut, it's really quite simple. I'll just hit Shift A on my keyboard to add a new mesh, and we'll add a basic torus. Okay, now I'll just open this menu. I'm just gonna increase the major segments and the minor to 32. Maybe I'll increase the major to 128. Okay, so the major segments are 128 and minor are 32. Now you can play with the major radius and the minor radius. I'm just gonna reduce the radius until it looks like a donut. Now we'll work on the material. So I'll just split my screen and I'll bring this donut into focus and I'll turn the gizmos off. Okay, now in this screen, I want to bring up the shader editor. So I'll just go up here where it says editor type, and I'll change the editor type to shader editor. So now we have our shader editor. Okay, now I'll just select this donut and I'll add a new material. So you can hit this new button. Now I have a basic material. Okay, now I'll add an emission shader. I'll hit Shift A again and I'll add a mix shader. I'll pop this mix shader between the principled and the material output, and I'll connect the emission into the bottom socket. You can interchange the order, it doesn't matter. In the principled, I'll change the color to completely black. Bump up the specularity to 1. It's time to make that pattern texture. So for that, I'm just going to use a special kind of texture, and that is a Musgrave texture. So I'll just hit Shift A, and under the texture panel, I'll just add a Musgrave texture. Under the converter, I'll add a color ramp. Connect the factor into the factor of this color ramp. Color of this color ramp goes into the factor of the mix shader. So now this texture decides how these two shaders are mixed. For now, I'm just going to change the emission color. I'll change some settings in this Musgrave texture. Okay, now for the rainbow color, the emission controls the color of those stripes, as you can see. So we need to plug something into the color right here. I'll just duplicate this color ramp. So select this color ramp and hit Shift D. Okay, now I'll add one more thing, Shift A, and under the texture, I'll add a gradient texture. So this is just a basic gradient texture. You can control the amount of fading using these sliders. So what we'll do is we'll change the mode from linear to ease first, and then I'll hit this plus button a bunch of times. So as you can see, now I'm going to start changing the color. So I'll select this node. You can change the color from here. We have a cool rainbow colored pattern donut, so that looks quite cool. Now I'm quickly going to show you how you can animate this. I'll start at frame 1 and I'll hover my mouse here and I'll hit I. So just hit I. You can also right click on the scale and insert a keyframe, as you can see. And as you can see, this turns yellow, but you can't see a keyframe in our timeline. So what you have to do is I'll just change the editor type to the dope sheet. And as you can see, we have a yellow colored keyframe right here. Okay, so now that we can see our keyframe, I'll just select this keyframe and I'll hit Shift D to duplicate, and I'll just drag this to the last frame. So our first frame and our last frames are same. Now I'm just gonna go to frame 45. Yeah, that looks good. And I'm just gonna right click here and insert a keyframe. I'm just gonna select all of these keyframes. So you can just tap your A key until they turn yellow. And I'm just gonna hit my V key. And I'm just gonna select the vector option. And I'm just gonna go back to my timeline. Okay, so that's it. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, you can leave a like down below. It helps a lot. And also subscribe to the channel for more tutorials like this. And I'll see you in the next tutorial.